Greetings in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. My name is Zel. With my wife Yemi and our daughters Ella and Joanna, we live in Brooks, Alberta, in Canada. Brooks Evangelical Free Church is our home church. I also serve as a pastor of Grace Christian Fellowship, an Ethiopian-Eritrean church in Brooks. This is a short video introduction of the Amharic Bible Dictionary endeavor I have been working on in the last several years. Amharic is the official language of Ethiopia, and Ethiopia is located in the northeast of Africa. Let me start with the population of Ethiopia. The population of Ethiopia has quadrupled in the last 50 years. In these same years, the population of many developed countries has only doubled. Relative to the general population, the census shows that Ethiopia is a Christian majority country. According to the 2007 census, Christianity is 62.8%, Islam 33.9%, traditional religions is 2.6%, and others are 0.6%. Breakdown of the 62.8 Christian population shows that the Ethiopian Orthodox Church comprises 43.5%, Evangelicals constitute 18.6%, and Catholic is 0.7%. The Ethiopian Orthodox Church is rich in age and colorful in liturgy. There are sparks of reformations at some levels. However, generally speaking, the heart of Christianity is lost in the liturgies and the traditions, and faith is only nominal. As well, in many evangelical churches, solid biblical and theological teachings are lacking. There are reasons for this lack. One of the major reasons is the acute shortage or even absence of biblical resource materials. Materials such as Bible dictionaries, lexicons, word study books, and concordances are not in short supply in Ethiopia. There are virtually none of them. Do you know how many Bible dictionaries there are in the English language? 40? 200? 500? Once I started counting and got exhausted after counting some 650. There are well over 2,000 different Bible dictionaries in English. What about in Amharic? Only one. This one was published by the Ethiopian Bible Society. While this is a commendable and worthwhile effort, it is only a 270-page work published in 1980. Well over 30 years in use now, it is reprinted many times without any revision. Also, it has many extra biblical entries and has pages and pages of unnecessary pictures. The current church growth and the need for biblical and theological hunger demands a larger, extensive material. The Amharic Bible Dictionary I am working on is an endeavor to alleviate this shortage, or rather lack of biblical resource materials. I want to speak a little about this endeavor. When I graduated from Trinity Western Seminary in 1994, the burden of the lack of biblical resource materials was heavy on my shoulders and in my heart. In 1995, I served the Ethiopian Church in Vancouver, Canada, and returned to Ethiopia. In 1996, I started my work in the Literature Department of the Ethiopian Kalehiwot Church Head Office. Kalehiwot Church is by far the largest evangelical denomination in Ethiopia. There were other options offered, but I chose to work in this department to work on the biblical resource books. As soon as I started work, I proposed a preparation of reference books, especially Bible dictionary in the Amharic language. The proposal received a very warm welcome. To avoid duplication of work, I checked if other churches or parachurch organizations are working on similar projects. There were none. In 1996 to 97, my job focused on the groundwork of doing the project proposal, planning, outlining, gathering entries, and training. The main work was to be done by some 70 writers in the span of 4 years between 1998 and 2002. Once the initial phase of my part was completed, I requested the needed funds to flow and the writers begin their work. That was when the office revealed lack of fund. This situation has bottlenecked the effort. Kalehwat Church, being the largest evangelical denomination in the country, at that time it had about 3.5 million membership. I thought the proposed amount could be available in the 4-year work span. Once the plan proved unredeemable, I returned all the work done that far to the office and started to minister in my local church in Debrezate. After I left the head office, I discussed about the work once with the then General Secretary of the Ethiopian Kalehwat Church. In 1999, I came to Canada. Though the burden of the Amharic Bible Dictionary work was lifted off of my shoulders, it was still in my heart, and I started to work from scratch anew. Between 2000 and 2003, I finished the entries of the first 4 letters of the Amharic alphabet, H, L, another H, and M. At this point, I asked a church and a mission organization in Ethiopia to sponsor me to do this full-time. Those two were interested initially when we started the work. That didn't materialize, and I continued the work. Between 2003 and 2007, 4 more letters of the alphabet were added. After that, it really slowed down. Some works were lost due to computer crashes and font software incompatibilities. Now I am working on B, the 10th letter of the alphabet. About 30% of the work is completed. All this is done in my after-work hours. I am a tent-making pastor, still. God willing, I want to finish this work in the span of 3 to 4 years. Trusting God, currently we are support raising as apprentice missionaries with EFCCM, Evangelical Free Church of Canada Mission. We encourage you to be part of this challenging task. As the Holy Spirit prompts you, pray for us. And as God prospers you, support us. May God bless you and make you a blessing in His kingdom.